Whisk. We use whisk for making buttermilk to stir the curd so buttermilk can form. We use a rolling pin. Rolling pin is used to make roti circular and uniform. Hello and welcome. Hope you are doing well. Today we are going to learn a chapter from 3rd standard NCERT book. Looking around, the name of the chapter is What is Cooking? Utensils you can see into this picture after coloring the background. You can see spatula. You can turn the rotis using spatula. You can see perforated spoons. These spoons are used to fry something. If we fry some chips, we can remove the chips out of that pan using these spoons. These spoons are known as perforated spoons. Again, frying pans, you can see three different frying pans. One is flat and another is with handle and another is without handle. The other is a cooking pot, we can say cooker also. And the other utensil you can see here is pitcher. We use it for water sewage, right? Are there other utensils which you use in your house? Yes, we use whisk. We use whisk for making buttermilk to stir the curd so buttermilk can form. We use a rolling pin. Rolling pin is used to make roti circular and uniform. Another tool we use in kitchen is grater. Grater has a rough surface, and on that surface if we rub any vegetable, for example if we rub carrot there, so we can have small pieces of the carrots. So that is use of grater. We also use earthen pots, small earthen pots to make curd. What are the utensils made of? Utensils are used at home. Those may be of wood material, those may be of stainless steel, those may be of earthen material like soil material, those may be of glass material. So many materials are used to make utensils. You can also take example of porcelain or ceramic. We use ceramic and porcelain, these material, in our cup and saucer. Ask some elders what type of utensils were used earlier, what were they made of. Those were made of brass material, copper material, soil material, and sometimes silver also. Some utensils are made of silver. Go to the kitchen and observe which food items are being cooked. So you have to write the steps of the sequence. All right, let's see how the leafy vegetables are cooked. First, wash the leafy vegetables, then cut it down in small pieces, then make tadka. Tadka is oil and adding rai and some spices in that, and add the leafy vegetables, cutted leafy vegetables into that tadka, and sprinkle some water and cook it. Add some salt according to your taste. Remember, we always steam the vegetables, right? We don't boil the leafy vegetables. We always steam the vegetables. We wrote the steps that how to cook leafy vegetables. Now we are going to list out the items we have seen into kitchen being cooked. Okay, first is upma, then idli, then dosa, poha. So we see many items being cooked in kitchen. You can write your own items also. We see into kitchen that there are roasted food items, there are baked food items. Okay, we are going to make a bifurcation into that. We are going to list out which are roasted, which are boiled, which are fried, and which are baked items. We are going to make the list of it. All right, roasted items, roasted peanuts, roasted chicken, roasted corn. All right, remember, roasting is the process is done on high flame. When there is exposure of actual flames there, actual heating flames there, there is the process of roasting. It is dry roasting actually. There is no addition of any water, or there is no sprinkling of water. So it is done in dry, purely dry roasting, like on high flame. Boiling is the process in which we boil the water and we add something into that boiled water. So this food items get cooked into that boiled water. So this is known as boiling. What we have in meal, like boiled meal, that is boiled potatoes, boiled eggs, and boiled rice. All right, frying is the process in which we heat the oil into frying pan, and if the temperature of that oil is good, like it is good enough, then we fry the food items into that oil. So fried items are wafers, potato chips, banana chips, puri and chakli. These are Indian dishes. We eat them by frying them. All right, baking is a process. It is done in oven, like on pans also foods are baked, but there is no direct connection with flames. Okay, there was directly connection of flames in the case of roasting, but in baking there is only a pan or there is only an oven. So we bake food items into oven. Those are biscuits, breads, muffins, cakes. All right, we have to match the pairs according to the how we generate heat for cooking purpose. We are going to match the pictures with the respective words. Kerosene oil is used in stove. They have shown the green stove. There they use kerosene oil. Coal is used in the second picture, the coal stove, we can say. Electricity is used in electric heater, electric baking machine, we can say. The gas is used in the gas cylinder, and using that gas cylinder connection, we cook the food items. Wood is used in the wooden stove. The sunlight is used in solar heating panel. Cow dung cakes, there is no any option in cow dung cakes. They have shown cow dung cakes also can be used in the wooden stove, right? Which food item does not need cooking? Buttermilk does not need cooking. Add some curd into a bowl. After adding into bowl, mix it and or blend it with whisk and add some water and add some salt according to taste. Next food item is coconut chutney. Add some coconut, add some ginger, some coriander leaves, and according to your taste you can add chili and salt to taste. Mix it well using mixer. The chutney is ready. Children, we have completed this chapter, so we will be back with another video. So stay connected to our channel, subscribe to our channel, like and share our videos. Team Ayansh looks forward to have written on that paper. They can only act like through their facial expression, through their hand movements, leg movements or body movements, but they cannot spell any word.